Hi boys, how are you? I hope you are enjoying your Google lessons. So, yesterday in my previous class, I discussed with you what is paragraph writing with the help of pointers. Today I am going to discuss what is process writing. That is again a paragraph with the help of some guidelines or some instructions. So, all of you know very well what a paragraph is. Yesterday only we discussed. So, just have a look at it once again. A paragraph is a group of sentences about one main idea. It can be short or long depending on if the topic or idea you have been covering has been fully explored in that paragraph. All the sentences are supporting the main idea. It is recommended that the paragraph should be no longer than 10 lines. Now, you understand very well what a paragraph is. A paragraph has a main idea. In the first sentence, that idea is explained. And then the rest of the sentences are logically connected with it, or they are further explanation of this idea, or some arguments can be given, or depends, you know, what type of paragraph you are writing. If it is a process, what we are going to do today, then you have to follow the guidelines or the instructions and write a paragraph depending upon the instructions. You have to develop those instructions in full sentences and you have freedom how to write those sentences. Okay, so let's go ahead. We have a simple paragraph and this paragraph is about washing clothes. Now, how to wash clothes? Instructions are given here. Let's look at these instructions. First, take a bucket of water, mix the water and the detergent well, put the dirty clothes in it and soak for an hour. Scrub the clothes, take out the clothes and rinse them in clean water and then wring out water and put them to dry. So, these are the instructions for washing clothes. Now, you are supposed to write a paragraph using these instructions. So, for you, I am giving you one paragraph which is making use of all these instructions. Now, so that you can learn how to write a good paragraph with the help of instructions. So, here it goes. To wash the clothes manually, take a fairly large bucket and fill it with water. Now look at the words that I am using. See, not necessarily that you restrict to these words which are given in the instructions. You can use your own words. So, add some detergent to the water and mix thoroughly. Immerse the dirty clothes completely into the soapy water and allow them to remain soaked for at least an hour. Take the clothes from the water and scrub them well using a clothes washing brush. Rinse the scrubbed clothes in clean water. Wring the clothes to squeeze out excess water and hang them outside on the clothes line to dry in the sun. So this is one paragraph based on these instructions. Now you can analyze, you can understand how these instructions have been used in this paragraph and you give it a heading, that is washing clothes. Right? Now all these ideas, all these sentences are connected with each other and when you are writing, you know, a paragraph that is about a process, you can start all your sentences with the verb look at them, take a fairly large bucket, fill it with water, add some detergent, right? Mix thoroughly, immerse the dirty clothes completely, and then allow them to remain soaked. Take the clothes from the water, scrub them well, rinse the scrubbed clothes, wring the clothes to squeeze out excess water, and hang them outside on the clothesline to dry in the sun. If you look at the structure of these sentences, all these sentences start with a verb. It is like you get the instructions and you follow those instructions, but you write them with the help of verb. Now, similarly, you will write another paragraph yourself with the help of instructions given, and that will be your assignment. Look at the instructions. Write a paragraph based on the instructions given, and the instructions are, this is the topic, how to prepare for exams, and this is a good topic since it's all useful for you. Now let's look at the pointers or the instructions, and using those instructions you will be writing a paragraph. First, give yourself enough time to study. I mean, it's not that you can just study in hurry or you can give more time to play games. Now let's look at the second point. Use flowcharts and diagrams. Now this is one is another instruction, and then comes practice and on old exams, you know, old papers. Then explain your answers to others. While you explain your answers to others, you always learn better, because anything that you are preparing, if you start teaching, that is the best experience to learn. Next one, organize study groups with friends. So you can make a group, small group of 2 to 3 students, and you can always study together in group, because when you are studying in group, you also discuss with each other, and you are able to express your doubts, you are able to express your answers, and you help each other. So all of you benefit in this process. Then next is, take regular breaks. I mean, you should not study continuously. You should study maximum for 40-45 minutes, and then take a break of 15 minutes, then again start. So regular breaks are required. You have to plan the day of your exam. Means the day you have your exams, you have to plan that day beforehand, how you are, you know, going to go, what all things you need, how you will travel, what time you will leave, everything about that day you have to plan in advance. And the last instruction is, while preparing for exams, drink plenty of water. So water is required very much to make your brain work better. So this, using these instructions, you write a paragraph yourself in your notebook, and that is your assignment for today. I hope you have understood. Give me your feedback. I always wait for that. Whether you have studied, whatever lesson you have studied, whether you have been able to understand or not, how you found it, I'm always looking forward to your feedback. Because these are not the normal lessons which we have been, delivering in the class. So these are different lessons, and I'm trying to make it simple for you. So please do write to me. Bye then. Take care.